Now we are going to finally solve the last problem, and this is the last example, and example is example 3.9. Slightly different from the rest of the examples. In this one we will utilize again the solution in the form of Legendre polynomials. Let me read the statement of the problem. A specified charge density sigma naught of theta is glued over the surface of a spherical shell of radius r. Find the resulting potential inside and outside the sphere. So we will have to find the potential inside and outside of the sphere when on the surface of the sphere some surface charge density has glued over, and we will have to find the potential inside and outside the sphere. There is one way that we write V equals to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and integral sigma naught dA and over r. This we have done already in the earlier chapters, and this way we can solve this problem. Here it is easier to solve with the help of the Legendre polynomials. So we are having basically a situation in which we will write the terms for the inside of the sphere and for the outside of the sphere. So when r is less than r, we are inside the sphere, then V of r and theta is equal to AL and r to the power L. Okay, this is, don't forget to write the summation, L run from 0 to infinity, AL RL and PL of cos theta. This is basically the r less than r situation when we are inside the sphere. So because when we are inside the sphere, as we did in the previous example, the AL is giving the value, means while the BL is blowing up the polynomials, the equation. So the BL is 0 here while AL remains, while for the outside of the sphere the summation runs from 0 to infinity, and this will be then the BL, while the AL is blowing up, and BL RL plus 1 and PL of cos theta for r greater equals r. So in this situation we will have the equation like this. Now these two solutions can be combined easily when we are at the r equals r. So when we will have the r equals r, then the two solutions will be equal, and I can write that summation on L from 0 to infinity AL r to the power L and PL cos theta here, PL cos theta here is equal to summation on L from 0 to infinity and BL r to the power L plus 1 and PL of cos theta. So they are being equal at what point? At r equals r. So here this r will become equal to capital R and this r will become equal to capital R, and they are equal. And from here means PL cos theta is gone with PL cos theta, so I can write BL in terms of this. So the summation on the terms are the same, so I can write that the BL will be equal to AL and r to the power L, and here L plus 1 will multiply with this one, so it will be r to the power 2L plus 1, because L into L plus 1 will become R to the power 2L plus 1. Now, we have already done in chapter 2 that when we are crossing the surface of this sphere, for example, this is the surface of a sphere and a charge density is glued on its surface. So, if we start from the center, we are having one kind of situation. As we try to cross the surface, then there is a discontinuity over here because charge density is there. And that discontinuity we have done in equation 2.36, and it is also shown here in the SNAP. You can just go there to refresh your memories, and then this discontinuity is given by the curly V out by curly R minus curly V N, means the potential out in N at points when R is equal to R. We have this thing equal to 1 over epsilon naught sigma naught minus here minus 1 over epsilon naught sigma naught of theta. So here we are having this discontinuity because the surface of the sphere is having this charge over it. So from here we are having an alternate equation, and this we do calculate because we are having our equation like this. That this is for the out, means this is the out and this is the in. So we will differentiate it with respect to R, we will differentiate this with respect to R, and then I can write for the first one, if I look then of the out with respect to R. So look here that when we do of this one, this R when goes up here, then it is R to the power minus L plus 1. So minus L plus 1 will come out, and then minus L plus 1 minus 1 divide will be the upper part here. So it, when I will make it at R equal to R, then R minus L minus 1 minus 1, so it will become 2 here, and L will become, when it will come down, then it will become positive, and I can do it quickly here, no problem. Then this will be this will be R L plus 1, so this will be R minus L plus 1, and I am differentiating it with respect to R. So what it will be? It will be minus L plus 1 and then R to the power minus L plus 1 minus 1. So it will be minus L plus 1 and R to the power minus L minus 1 becomes minus 2, so this will be minus L plus 1, and this is R minus, if I take common, then it will become 2, so L plus 2 here means minus L plus 2, minus, when it goes down, then becomes plus, so L plus 2 here, and when I do calculate it at R equal to capital R, then I will have the this thing here. So let me write this result here, that this will be from minus summation on L from 0 to infinity, and L plus 1, the minus I have written here, and then L plus 1 and BL, and here I will write capital R, but this will be L plus 2 here, and PL of cos theta, and minus, this will be summation on L from 0 to infinity, And what about this one? This will be L times AL in RL minus 1. So L times AL in RL minus 1 in PL of cos theta. And this thing is equal to minus 1 over minus 1 over epsilon naught in sigma naught of theta. So we can now use the BL we have found earlier. So for BL I can write this value. So this will become equal to AL r to the power 2L plus 1. So r 2L plus 1, then it will be simplified. When r will go up, then 2L minus L will become L, and then 1 minus 2 will become minus 1. So I can, means it's simple, so I will just write the result that summation L runs from 0 to infinity, and 2L plus 1 AL RL minus 1 in PL of cos theta is equal to minus 1 over epsilon naught in sigma naught of theta. So we have found it here. And now we will find the value, because our job is to find the value of AL. And AL we will find with the traditional Fourier trick. We will multiply this thing with PL prime of cos theta and sine theta and d theta. Means we will multiply this with PL and sine the PL of cos theta, PL prime of cos theta and sine theta we will multiply, and then we will integrate with respect to theta, and the integration will be basically from 0 to pi. So when we do this thing, then we will get, I have done this in three examples. So here I will just write the result directly, that AL comes out to be equal to 1 over 2 epsilon naught and RL minus 1, and this is from 0 to pi, 0 to pi, and sigma naught of theta in PL of cos theta sine theta d theta. Okay, this is what that we have reached. Now here it is given the means when sigma naught of theta is specified, then we can find this AL. In the book we are given now with the sigma naught of theta, that this is equal to k times cos theta, and cos theta I can write is p1 of cos theta. So it means that only L equal to 1 is here working in this solution, while all rest of the all terms will be 0. So if I do this thing and I write here AL, and this is 1 over 2 epsilon naught, this will become R, and 1 minus 1 is 0, 0 to pi, and sigma naught here. For sigma naught, I can write P1 of cos theta, K P1 of cos theta is K cos theta. So I will write K cos theta and then sine theta d theta. So this is the P1 of cos theta, and k equals this one. So I have just written PL of cos theta is here. Okay. For sigma naught, I have written k cos theta, and then for PL of cos theta, 1 cos theta will come in there, so it will become cos square theta, and sine theta d theta is here. So this will result the solution. This one is very easy to find, and because when k is constant, it will come outside, the in front of cos theta is its derivative sine theta d theta. So we will have this cos cube theta by 3, and then we will put the limit 0 to pi, and we can easily get the solution, which is equal to k over 3 epsilon naught. So we have found the solution A. This is basically now equal to A1, because L is equal to 1. So we have found the solution. When we determine this thing, then we have found the solution, and I can now easily write that V of R theta is equal to A1, means here A1 and R power 1, so in PL of cos theta. So A1 is equal to K over 3 epsilon naught, and r power 1, and then p1 of cos theta, and this is equal to cos theta. So this is the solution for r less than r, and when we write v r of theta, and this thing is for the r greater or equal to r, and this is equal to bl this. So bl I will write in terms of this. This value I will have to put in stead of BL, and then R1 plus 1 I will specify, then I will get K in R cube over 3 epsilon naught and 1 over R square cos theta, and this is for R greater or equal to R. So we have found with this thing the two situation, inside and outside the sphere, the potential. Similarly, we can calculate the induced charge just by applying that formula, and this has done the job. And we are done with all the examples. I hope you will practice on them and will learn a lot. There are problems at the end, so you can try those problems and well to get more confidence.